the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go and anoint Jesus' body. And very early, on the first day of the week when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb? Who will roll away the stone for us from the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him just as he told you." So they went out and they fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. During this church year known as Year B, we are using both the gospel of St. Mark and the gospel of St. John as our faithful witnesses to the story of Jesus Christ and that journey of his on the pathways in this world. The four Gospels each have their unique way of expressing God's love for us in the revelation of Jesus Christ, God's Son. Today, we encounter St. Mark's account of the resurrection, which seems to differ from St. John's account that we walked with in our Easter vigil service last night. In the John account, Mary Magdalene finds the grave empty, goes and tells the male disciples. The guys sprint to the tomb, racing each other to see who can get there first, check the tomb out for themselves, find out that the same information that Mary found out. Then they ran away and don't do anything about the tomb being empty. Now Mary comes back to the tomb to see what she can do. She takes a second look into that hollowed out rock, and she encounters an angel this time. She speaks briefly with him, turns around, and there is Jesus face to face with her. She believes at first that he's the gardener, as we are told, until Jesus calls her by name. Then Mary ran and told the other disciples that she had seen the Lord. She gave them that news. You know, I saw a truth-telling sign this past week that read, "Without women preachers, we would have no knowledge of the resurrection." Thanks to Mary Magdalene, our first century woman preacher. Thanks be to God. In Mark's account today, two other women are with Mary Magdalene. They encounter an angel who tells them that Jesus has risen from the dead. And this time the women run in terror and amazement. St. Mark's account continues on. This is the end of St. Mark, in a textually disputed ending to the gospel, describing the other witnesses to Christ's resurrection, the ones that Luke tells us about in the Acts passage today, and Paul describes in the Epistle passage as well. These accounts of Jesus' post-resurrection appearances, some of which we will be reading in the next few weeks in this season of Easter, show Jesus as being in various forms, in which his face may not be recognized to his friends. And while Jesus had physical nail prints in his hands, as we will note next week, he also was able to move in and out of rooms without using doors. however it was that people encountered Jesus after his death and resurrection. It was very similar to the way in which they encountered him in his ministry on the pathways. Each was touched in a unique way, and they often could not explain it in words. The blind man who was healed by Jesus said it best, "Look, people, all I can tell you is I was once blind, but now I see." You can continue to do the math, and you can continue to fight with each other about how this could possibly happen. But God has moved in my life and has raised me to a new way of living. My friends, once you have encountered the resurrected Christ, your life is changed. It is that life-giving breath of God that filled the lungs of creation that has the power to resurrect the dead. It is that word uttered by God that spoke this world into existence that has the power to call the dead out of the tomb. It is the Word made flesh who dwelt amongst us, who calls us by name, knows our story before we share it. He sits with us and he listens. He knows when we are terrified. He knows when we are amazed. It is Jesus Christ who makes the impossible possible. It is the terrifying and amazing work of the Holy Spirit that God meets each and every one of us right where we are. Even when we choose the path that leads away from God, God in his great grace and mercy finds a way to encounter us on the road. Even when we believe that we are the furthest from God, in the situations in life in which we have found ourselves, even when we believe that we are the furthest away from God in the situations in which we find ourselves in this life, a voice comes from a stranger calling us by name. That familiar voice that called us into this world calls us up out of our grave and invites us to walk the pathway into eternity with him. This is the day that the Lord has made. Our risen Lord invites us to celebrate resurrection life, to see resurrected life at work in ourselves, to be those lowly shepherds on the plain the night that Jesus was born, the ones that the angels appeared to and announced that the good news was for them and for all people. Christ invites us to see resurrected life in each other, to look at the least, the lost, and the lonely in this world and call them by name, call them the name that Jesus gave them, blessed. The Holy Spirit pushed us out into the desert with Jesus at the beginning of Lent, right after descending upon Jesus at his baptism. This resurrection day, the Holy Spirit of God has ripped open the veil that separates us from God, and we rise with Christ who has conquered death, hell, and the grave. Perhaps Mark's gospel ends in that complex way so that we don't settle in nice and cozy as if we had read the last page in the book. Resurrection life continues. God surprises us around every corner. Mark invites us to how the book opens. This is just the beginning of the good news of Jesus.